Welcome to our video of us doing the flame test lab together. Hopefully before you watch this video, you've already watched the pre-lab, so you understand the theory and the chemistry behind what you're going to experience today in lab. And then you also should have printed the lab handout. It is double-sided, and you'll need the front and the back to record your data. So if you haven't printed it yet, please pause the video and print both pages of the lab. So to give you a general sense of what we'll be doing in this lab today, we're actually going to be flame testing some metal ions. As you know from the introduction, as we introduce energy in the form of heat into these atoms, it takes their electrons and excites them from a ground state to an excited state. And then when they fall back down to their ground states, they re-radiate that energy in the form of light. And so what we're doing today is we are flame testing some metal ions, and we're observing the colors that they exhibit as their electrons again fall from that excited state to their ground state and release that energy in the form of light. Again, the idea is that the light is representative of energy, which then gives us an idea of position, which then led us to the Bohr model of the atom. So doing these in order, as you see in step two in the lab, we already have our microwell tray all set up with all of our solutions. We have barium, calcium, copper, then potassium, lithium, sodium, and strontium. And then we have three unknowns that we'll be looking at down in step six of the lab. We've already broken up our Q-tips, and they've been soaking for a little while, and we are now ready to flame test these metals. So you'll notice we are going to place the Q-tip, which is soaked in these ion solutions, in the flame, and what we'll see at first is a yellow color as the water boils off of the solution. The color that we're looking for then is the color that follows after the water is gone. This is our barium. And that is the color that is representative of barium here at the tip of this flame. We will re-dip and come back. And that is the color that's indicative of of barium being flame tested. Be careful that you don't confuse it with the orange at the end when the Q-tip actually catches on fire. So take a second. If you need to pause the video, that's totally fine. And down in your data chart, record that color. We're now going to move on to calcium. We will soak that Q-tip. And here then is the calcium flame test. There we go. We'll re-dip, come back. And the color that you see there is the flame test color for calcium. Now coming back to copper, moving on to copper. We lost the copper color in the flame of the Q-tip. We'll come back again. There we go. This color over here on the right-hand side, there it is. That's a very vivid copper flame test color. We're moving on then to potassium. Potassium is K on the periodic table. This is our flame test then for potassium. That's our color there. Not over here on the left, but to the right is your flame test for potassium. Let's do that again. And again, it's the color on the right that you're observing, the color over here. All right. So there's our flame test for potassium. Next, we're going to do lithium. comes our lithium flame test. This one tends to be pretty vivid. There we go. Let's do that again. That's great. There's our flame test color for lithium. Now we're going to move on to sodium. Two more to go. Here comes sodium. That's it right there. There we go. Wow, that's great. There's our sodium color. We're just going to let that go because that's perfect. All right, there we've got our flame test for sodium. And then the final metal ion that we will flame test is strontium. And that's a great flame test for strontium. Maybe go one more dip for you. And there's our strontium flame test. Oh, that was good. All right, so now that you've had the opportunity to observe the flame test colors for those seven elements, we're moving on now to step six. And in step six of the lab, what you're being instructed to do is access three unknowns, lettered A, B, and C. And we are now going to flame test these three unknowns. Each of these unknowns contains one of the seven ions that you already flame tested. And so you will be asked to identify what these unknowns contain based upon their flame test colors and comparing them with the colors that you already observed. Certainly, you can use your color descriptions in your data chart as a starting point. But if you need to rewind this video and go back and compare color to color, that would certainly be a good idea as well. So turn your lab over or go to the second page, and you'll notice on the back it says unknown A, B, and C. And then there's a place to write down the colors that you observe when we flame test these. But then notice off to the right, you're being asked to identify what metal these unknowns contain. And again, you'll do that through comparison. So we are now going to flame test unknown A. So this is A on the left.
Yes.
Okay. Here comes unknown A. Let's give that another dip. Got a little bit of smoke and flame from the Q-tip itself. There we go. There's our unknown A. Let's do that one. Oh, lost it. Unknown A one more time. There it is. That's our unknown A. That's the color that you want to make your decision off of. All right, so there's unknown A. Let's move on then to unknown B. There's your color for unknown B over here in what should be the right-hand side of your image. Let's do that again. There it is. There's your color for unknown B. And now let's go back and let's do unknown C. And here we go. That's a great result for unknown C. Maybe give you a little bit more of that one. All right. There's your unknown C. So as we said, feel free to stop and rewind and move around in this video as you need to do your comparisons. Please know that we will be grading your identity of the ions that you identified in your unknowns and then all of the conclusion questions. Please be careful as you answer these conclusion questions. The answers can be found, or at least the concepts and terms you need to know can be found in the pre-lab discussion. So if you haven't yet, go back and reference that, and then fill out the conclusion questions on the lab. And if you are watching this and coming back, well, as soon as you come back to school, you'll be turning this lab into your teacher. Regardless of why you were gone, this will be due as soon as you return. So fill it all out and be ready to turn this in when you come back to school. There you go. Enjoy. Good luck with the write-up.